like the hipster deck right now. By the way, I really like how Anorak on the most recent Eternal Glory podcast pronounced it Snow Mana. That sounds so German. Snow Mana. Fucker Snow Deck. You don't really care about Magic anymore, but you're still watching me. So, oh, thank you so much. That means a lot to me. Even though you actually ended up spreading the rumor that I wasn't ever wearing pants at tournaments. Akash, hey, does it? Does it really? I don't know. It can suck at times, but that's part of the thrill. I'm really popular in Ukraine. I don't know about that. But maybe I am. That would be like really cool, but I wouldn't know about that. I actually had a lot of guys from Brazil message me at times. And China. China, like, I actually ended up going to China last December on invitation from, like, I want to say, like, the Chinese legacy scene. And that was really cool. I played in the Olaf tournament in Beijing. I really want to go back. Had so much fun there. Like, to be honest, like, I wasn't always that interested in China. Like, I was a guy, like, I liked South Korea, or I still do, because of, like, the old StarCraft thing and growing up and then seeing that and being fascinated. And also Japan, because of, like, the Japanese foreign culture. I guess they call it Weibo or something, if you like that. And then there was China, and China was, like, this big thing. And China interested me, like, very much on a political level, but not so much, like, on a cultural level. But then you actually get to know it, and you, like, hear about, like, a lot of things going on there. And you visit it, and, whoa, I want to go back. Germany isn't very popular in Ukraine. Maybe because of Nord Stream 2. Yeah, people don't really talk that much about it, but it's mentioned like once in a while. So, what's the opponent playing, by the way? Oh, it looks like we might be getting lucky. It looks like they picked the Hogak deck. So, that means their interaction is 4 Cable Therapies, which they might just hit while I didn't notice. Postbot Canonist and stuff. Okay, so how are we gonna get there? 1 mana, 2 mana, 3 mana? Now we need to find something. But right now things are looking pretty good, especially if we can get generate some storm and find rituals. They actually have Cable Therapy in hand, but didn't go for it. Ooh. So next turn we're gonna get destroyed. Next turn our hand is gonna get destroyed. If there is gonna be a next turn though. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's pretty far. So they have Entomb Chemotherapy. Is this a zombie? Yeah, okay. So they can even Entomb for another Chemotherapy. So we probably should play like everything we have and then hope to top deck something eventually. This. 1, 2, 3. Rest doesn't really do anything. Probably should also play the Koromox because they will eventually take that away. It's kind of awkward to imprint Rite of Flame because Rite of Flame is just as good in the graveyard if you draw another one. Actually, it's still better to have it on the Chromox here. We could even play the another Chromox just for... Actually, I wouldn't hate that. Just for the Metalcraft. Actually, but they wouldn't discard. You wouldn't discard. You wouldn't download a Chromox, would you? See you, Jenkintaxis. Good to see you again. Maybe you're gonna see you at some GP. You know, nobody ever really quits Magic, they say. I think this is one of those F6 moments now. But we really should try to win the first game. Second Stitcher Supplier. Ooh. Oh, this is gonna give them Hogak. Well, it's gonna give them Hogak, but unless they find a land, it's not gonna give them another... Let's move this. Okay, with therapy, if they have to... Is this gonna do it? Probably not. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Probably should still play this. Just at this point, we're really just looking for a draw 7, but Windfall isn't even gonna do it, which is kind of awkward. I wonder whether I actually wanna. No, I don't wanna imprint Mind's Desire, because if they make me discard it and I draw. Well, if I draw Burning Wish, I would probably just go. Actually, I could also go for Mixique's Mastery from the graveyard, which might be better. Let's see what they're gonna be up to. Speaking of hipster cities, probably should visit the. I've heard about that, actually. At least about the name. Didn't they also have some matches in the 2012 Euros there? Half cities, beer brewers. Like, See, the thing is, I don't like beer. I've only had beer twice in my entire life, and I hated it each time. And it like, every time I had beer, it took, like, a millionaire to buy me a beer and be like, you know, you gotta drink this, check it out. And I was like, okay, let's do that. Okay, so there goes my mox. Now we're actually looking to top deck something like Burning Wish, which is kind of funny because I always hate Burning Wish in decks like this. Ha. Huh. So should we try to... Actually, we have to brainstorm to something here anyway, because next turn we are dead. So we go for the brainstorm, and then we crack this for, I would guess, red. And actually should tap this one as well, and the other one for blue. And then we're going to see where the brainstorm is going to take us. Take me down to the river. Let's do it like this. And then we're gonna mana Morphose into the brainstorm. Into the Burning Wish. We're gonna add this. So what are we gonna try to find here? So at this point we got Storm 4 going on. Or Storm 3 there, rather. Mastery, Exile Target, Cried for instance, Sorcery from Griff. Try to exile this way, copy it, and you may cast a copy, so it actually adds to the storm in that regard. So we would go for 4, we could go for the top 5 cards. I'm breaking stereotypes, yes, very much. So we can go Mind Sea Scythe from here. We can, is there anything else? We can draw 7, I'm not sure if that's better than going for Mind Sea Scythe. The thing is, like, we know the actually no, Mind Sea Scythe shuffles every time, as far as I remember, right? Shuffle your library, okay, that's great. So, for 4 mana, we can Mind Sea Scythe here. I think that's probably the way to go. Or is it, though? Could be... Would I rather draw 7? I mean, okay. I did not come here to play Mind Sea Scythe. Or did I? And then not cast Mind Sea Scythe. I kind of want to do Mind Sea Scythe for 5. I'm just not sure it's actually going to do it. But it's Mind Sea Scythe time, come on. Can I actually overload it? No! Oh, I almost accidentally clicked something. What if I overloaded 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, I can't overload it. It actually wouldn't be all that good. It would be actually would be good. So let's do this. Cast a copy of Mind Sea Scythe. Yes, cast. So we get 5 things altogether. Let's see what we are gonna get. Where is it actually gonna put the stuff that I get? Probably somewhere. Okay, we get the Rite of Flame, we don't need that. Taxing Probe can help us. Okay, more mana. Okay, now we got a hit. This is bad. Then maybe we should have drawn 7. The mana, I'm not that concerned. Maybe I should have drawn 7. Somebody in the comments is gonna tell me you should have drawn 7. But maybe we still end up drawing 7, who knows? Carrion Feeder and Entomb. Okay. Fuck. Well, that looks pretty dead. Well, get a bunch of mana. And then that's gonna be it. Is there like a flashback on something? No, we don't really have any flashback on something. Okay. Too bad. I did the right thing. It's good to end up dying knowing that you did the right thing. So what are we gonna look... What are we looking to beat? 4 Cavotherapy. 2 Thought Seizers. Canonists can be a problem, but they come down turn 2. Ley Lines we probably can beat, where Tire doesn't really do too much to us. Honestly, they can't interact on the first turn, so we should probably just go all in on the first turn. Like, I could see Fluster, Storms, over, I don't even know what. We're sure I had mana for Overload. Yeah, I think I was one short the way I saw it. Day you turn down a Mind Sea Scythe, the turn you're gonna stop playing Storm. See, I like man, actually that sounds like so stupid, I have like people that have principles. So, I'm just trying to figure out whether I want Flusterstorm. I probably don't want Flusterstorm. You know, we're just gonna kill them on the first turn. They don't really... Like, what do they have? They have Ley Lines that they probably won't even bring in. And then they have some discard. Like, I could actually see bringing in Flusterstorm on the draw, but on the play... They're just gonna beat this deck, you know? That does the thing. One drop because he did not imprint Desire the turn before. That's a good point, actually. Hiccup. But it was kind of cool to actually see the brainstorm get there. Well, what's the sicker thing? And Let's not lose this one. Is this... Oh, I just realized this deck is actually playing much less business than the previous one. I think the previous one also played like 3 Winefalls. This deck isn't even playing Winefall. This deck is much slower in that regard, actually. But... You know what? I kind of want to keep this. I don't hate that. We're going to have a bunch of mana and then we can draw into something. We also have 2 business spells, even though Burning Wish... Like I said, Burning Wish is not exactly the kind of business card I really like. Bam, 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 bam. Sorry, Miss Chalkson.
I'm for real.
Never meant to make your daughter cry. Why does it actually... Oh, I see. And then we got this.
We move to this. And then sounds like this. Okay.
We got it. Hermit combo too strong. Did Hermit actually do something? Hermit was one of the cards I expected to heavily underperform. I also think that Earthcraft is like not gonna perform, but actually I played against someone, I don't remember whom, and they had an Earthcraft deck, like for practice, and it was not horrible. Like, it was actually okay. So let's see what Mr. Guldcut is up to. Show me your colors. Oh fuck, they have Thoughtseize into Caver Therapy, into looting. Okay, let's kill them on this turn. If there's any way we can do that. Doesn't really look like. Okay, so this one should probably go into play. So should this. You know what? I should have actually played the Ancient Tomb now that I think about it. Because next turn if I draw a red source, then I can't wheel. And I'm probably gonna take away the wheel, but there's always a chance they don't. Blend scan. That must be Thoughtseize, right? There would be some serious balls if they went Faithless Looting first here. Against the crazy Storm deck that kept 7. Thoughtseize. They probably have to take Wheel of Fortune, right? I mean, Burning Wish doesn't really do anything. Is there anything we... Ooh, does this turn on something? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Actually, no, we don't. I was like, hey, no. Moxopal still legendary. Moxopal. What if we just make goblins? Well, we can't really do anything, right? So, what if we just do nothing? Gonna play this, because I probably just want to top deck something that draws 7. 1, 2, 3, 4 mana still. So for 2 mana, I can't really do anything, and anything else I do, they flashback. I'm actually 1 mana short of wheeling, which would be so sweet. But we need more. I think that's a Mystic Mastery. Can't be cast from graveyard. Nah, I think this is just gonna be a pass. A pass and then having our Burning Wish taken out. I kinda like it. I kinda like it because like this version of the deck compared to last week feels quite a bit slower, but maybe I'm wrong. And in this matchup, I feel like where I'm supposed to be is I have a bunch of mana, and then I top deck something. Unless you outright kill them. But if you don't, then I think you're more like a critical mass deck. But I could be very wrong. Like, I've only played so many matches with this deck thus far, right? Oh, this must be Bloodgast. Oh, Bloodgast is sweet, because then they can... Yeah, then they can take out 2 cards with Caper Therapy. Or can they? Well, not this turn. Sorry, Miss Jackson. I'm for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. I apologize a trillion times. So what are we gonna draw here? Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune might secretly be the most busted card in the entire league. I remember Anorak playing a burn deck with Wheel of Fortune, and even winning. Like, what is wrong with the world? We're just gonna pass, and now we're really just looking to draw something. Like, even Desire would actually... Well, we can't even cast Desire, it's awkward. We don't have enough blue mana. He didn't even cast it and just sided it out. That's too bad. What, he straight up played Burn then? He straight up won with Burn? Talk about being honest to yourself. It's like, hey, I don't know what else I'm well equipped to play, so let's just play Burn. You play, how the fuck do you beat Omni with Burn? Okay, that's pretty crazy. I like that. So, what's going on the other side, by the way? Probably don't really know much. I guess it won't be Hogak. I guess you can still make Hogak. How did you beat Omni with Burn? That's kind of crazy. Did you like disrupt them, or did it just like Omni collapse on itself? You know what this deck wants? Some flashback stuff. Bloodlust. You literally just goldfish them. Shouldn't they be like the better goldfish deck? Gravecrawl. Oh, now we got Hogak. Mr. Hogak. Show us your power. Is it actually Mr. Hogak? Could also be like Miss Hogak, Mrs. Hogak. Usually, if you want to know, you look at versions in German, because like German is very specific about genders. Lines are dumped. Okay, opponent. I wouldn't mind like finding something this turn, because we might actually be dead next turn. We take 12 here. Yeah, we literally need to top deck something now. Burn players usually don't know what their cards do. Well, it's actually not that hard to know what burn cards do, right? If people say they're Hogak, but is it really? Anyway, come on. Mind Seesire. No, actually, don't draw. Actually, may. Oh, fuck. Nah, if they can find bridge, we are pretty dead here. Don't you want to start killing your Hogak? Actually, no, yeah, it makes sense to kill the Hogak first, right? Because that gives you the highest chance of finding bridge. And then if you kill the other two, you get tokens. Okay, one bridge. Does one bridge already do it? I don't remember. I think they need the second bridge. Oh, well, they have the Black Ghast with the Polluted Delta, so that should also do it. Yeah, okay, too bad. Well, I think we're already considering the next deck to play, which might be... Should we play Survival or should we play Omni? Actually, you know what? I want to see as much Survival as we can, so we should definitely play Survival next. My Survival deck would have had an awesome graveyard board. This match doesn't feel like Vintage. Well, it's not Vintage, right? It's like Modern meets... bad draw out of a busted storm deck. No, it's not Omni plus Survival, that would be insane. Yeah, so yeah, but we have Omni left, we have Survival left, and we have Grixis Delver left. And I definitely want to play Survival next. So let's Survival it up. Actually, if you play against me, and I got my back against the wall, which I don't have right now, but if I'm like down two matches, and I haven't played Survival yet, you will know that Survival is going to come out next, because I really want to show off Survival. Omnivival. That's, you know, that's the straight to VHS sequel. Omnivival. Yeah, we look pretty dead here. I might just... It's actually kind of interesting. Probably, like, check my deck whether I have some grave interaction. This deck didn't feel nearly as powerful as it felt in the first week. Maybe you really want to have the Windfalls again. Maybe the totally busted kill me with your force referrals is the way to go. I wonder what he's scared of. Because I think he can just outright deck us now. Yeah, DRS plus, especially Quirin Ranger, kills very quickly. DRS plus Quirin Ranger is like 5 a turn. And then even more on the final turn. The thing is, like, when people say they miss XYZ, I totally, like, when I just played Deathrite Chain and Elves, I also realized, oh man, that card was so sweet in Elves. Thing is, I hate when any version of Grixis is viable in any format, because I think the Grixis playstyle is the ultimate insult to, like, good magic. It's really just like all about power and doing like this stuff that has no soul. I don't know how to put it. Like Grixis Like, Mardu literally makes me sick. I once played a game where I got sick, probably for other reasons, but like a lot of Mardu, doing Mardu was involved. Sounds like a drug. And that's how I ended up like hating Mardu. But also like what Mardu stands for. No elegance, no speed, no knowledge. It's straight up like a German tank. People say that's like the German tank deck. And it's like everything I don't like about Magic. And Grixis is close. Grixis is like the same thing, but in a good shell. I like Bant, I like Celestia, I like Simic. That's what I want. I can even appreciate Naya, even though I don't really want to play Naya. And yeah, Grixis, like, it's a psychological thing almost. Anyway, are we dead yet? Dude, how, you can't, what, where's your Hogak? Don't tell me you have to pass. Oh, there's Hogak. And he's got 3 bridges now, that should easily do it. He's down to 11 cards, that doesn't really help. That doesn't really help much, right? Has he already started? Yeah, okay, he started targeting us. Actually, let's maybe he knows something that we don't know. Is there anything in our deck that makes it so that we survive? No, right? Just end up getting decked. So let's not go for this. Okay, you got that match.